Hi, welcome back to our channel. In this video, we will make a lens hood using Designspark Mechanical. Anyway, for this topic, we will cut into two videos. The first one will be about how to make this one, the locking mechanism. And then the second one is how to make this one, the hood part. So if we already finished these two, it's going to be easy to combine these two items or two components. But now we will start by making the lock mechanism first. So in the front part, you might see some mechanism like this. It's a bayonet locking mechanism. So we can slide a lens hood here and it will lock in place with a tab here. So we will design a lens hood that will utilize this mechanism. To do that, we need to measure some points. So first, we need to measure the diameter of the front lens tube. In this case, for my lens, it's a MZUICO 1250mm. The diameter is 54.5mm, and then B is the diameter measured at the bayonet flange. So for this bayonet flange to the one at the other side, the diameter in this case is 56mm, and then C is the largest diameter of the lens assembly. So for this lens, the largest diameter is here, so this is 57mm, and then the bayonet track width is this track. The width is 2mm. And then next, this is the calculation result. So this number is actually the one that I'm using right now. You can use this number as an initial reference, but you can adjust as you need. So the result will depend on the material, nozzle, printer, and so on. For the lens hood bayonet tab, which is this one, this small tab that will cause locking into this between the pump and the stopper, it is going to be 0.2 plus the diameter of the front lens tube. So 54.5 plus 0.2 becoming 54.7 for the diameters. And then 4.82 is the lens hood bayonet flange. You can add allowance 0.8, so it becomes 55.3 for this one, the flange diameter. And then next one for the cutout. For the cutout is this one, the part that is cut like this. For the cutout, diameter is 0.8 plus the diameter of the measured at the bayonet flange. So 56 plus 0.8 becoming 56.8. Next is for the hood internal wall. Because the hood shape will be like a cylinder or a barrel, so the internal wall should not be smaller than the outer diameter of this lens. And we can add, in this case I add 3mm, so from 57 becoming 60mm. And then for the flange thickness or the mechanism thickness, it's going to be 2 minus 0.2, so 1.8mm. With some remark, we will need to add chamfer to make sure that the mechanism will go in this track smoothly. Next, we will use this calculation to make the drawing of the lens hood locking mechanism. So please open your Designspark Mechanical and we will start by making the first circle for this lens hood bayonet tab with 54.7mm. So circle 54.7mm. Okay, next, the second circle is this one, 55.3. Okay, so from the same center, 55.3. Okay, and then the next one for the cutout, 56.8. Okay, we will put here 56.8. And then the next one is for the hood internal wall, 60mm. Okay, from the same center, 60mm. Okay. Okay. Now we will also add for the wall thickness, which is not mentioned here, but it's also necessary to put now. So I will put from 60mm plus 2mm on each side, but we can adjust later on, no problem. So we will make a circle with 64mm diameter. Okay, I will click select and then let's see. Okay, now There are also things that we need to measure for the design, is the position of this tap and stopper and pump and so on. So three position that I check here is, first is the end of the flange. So I measure from this one, from the north coordinate 0 degrees, moving to here to this direction 30 degrees, okay. And then the tap start from 38 degrees here, okay. And then the tap will end on 42 degrees. So this is going to be the radius measurement that we will put into the drawing. So first we will make the 30 degrees line written to this one using the top view, and then 30 degrees from north. So if this shows 90 degrees, then 30 will be 60 degrees here. So I'm measuring from north, but this Designspark Mechanical is measuring from the right hand side, so it's okay, just some small mathematical calculation. And then next one is for the tap start at 38 degrees. So I will click here, and then 8 degrees from 60 is 52. Okay, and then the next one is 42 degree. 42 degree is 4 degree from this one, so I will click here, and we will move by 4 degree from 52, so it will be 48 here. Wait, yes, and don't forget to also put one line for the north, because we will make some copy later on. And then click select. Now click on this one, the 3D mode, okay. And then we will extrude the part that we need. For the tap, we need to click this one, because the diameter will include this line, the smallest circle, okay. And then click here and here, and then we will click pull, and then put 1.8 millimeters. Sorry, 1.8. Done. This is going to be the tap. And then for the flange, here and here, and then we pull by 1.8 millimeters. So we are not going to extrude this one, because this smallest diameter is only for the tap, but not for the flange. Okay. And then the next one is this one. This is for the cutout, which is the third circle. So meaning also this one. Okay. We will pull by 1.8. Okay. And then for the outer ring, this is for the lens hood cylinder, so we can pull more than 1.8. So let's put, for this prototyping step, please use small numbers first. So in this case I will put 3 millimeters. Okay, so yes, here we have the basic shape of the lens hood. So I will copy this surface, Control C and then Control V. Okay, now if I hide the solid, it will look like this. And then I will click this one, the move. And then I will flip by 180 degrees. Okay, now I will show again the solid. See, so we have a surface here that we can use to add the flange and tap. So we click pull, add, and then press U or up to this one, and then click this here. So we have a copy of the tap and flange symmetrically, or mirror copy. Now we will mirror copy this one to the bottom side. So we can use the same method, or we can also, because this is a symmetry, so you can also rotate by 180 degrees, no problem. In this case, I will copy Ctrl C and then Ctrl V, and then I will move the copied surface 180 degrees. Okay, and after that, I will also extrude or pull at up to the bottom part. Yes. Okay, we need to also add some chamfer here, so double click here so that these edges will be selected, and we will need to put chamfer to make sure that it will slide in nicely to the lens mechanism. Wait, it's a bit difficult to drag, so maybe need to close up. Yes, so put 0.4 for the chamfer. Okay, and then also at the other side, double click and until it select all these edges, and then again chamfer by 0.4. done. This is the printed version of this locking mechanism, so it has 1, 2, 3, 4 tabs and 2 flanges, and if we put on this lens, it will stick in place. You might hear the slight sound of locking and clicking. Okay, next we will design the lens hood that we will combine with this locking mechanism. If you have any question or suggestion, please put in the comment below. Don't forget to subscribe. I will see you again in the next video. Bye.